Welcome back, guys. Welcome back to my channel. Today in this short tutorial, I will show you guys how to make this blur effect in Adobe Photoshop. So you guys can use these techniques to create fur effect or even hair or grass or anything similar to this type of particle effects. All right, so let's get started. Okay, so now I'm going to draw the shape which we are going to apply the fur to. It can be any shape. For this example, I'm going to use the very basic shape, which is a circle in here. So I'll choose the ellipse and draw a small circle like this. Okay, maybe this circle and this color is fine. This can be any object, guys. You use this one for you guys to easily understand. Okay, and for this, since it's a vector shape, let's go in here and we don't need a stroke color, and also fill color, let's leave it like that. And guys, one more trick in here is keep the artwork size a little bit higher. When you finalize the artwork and make it smaller, the fur effect will look more realistic. All right. Okay, so now we can rasterize this layer and we can use this layer for our fur object. All right, so before we start, what we are going to do is we are going to make an illusion of fur object. In order to do that, we need to first define the light source. So as for any artwork, you guys always need to consider the lights and shadows before you guys start your artwork in 2D. All right, so for this, let's say, I'm going to change this color first. So let's say the light source is going to be in here. Okay, let's bring this one a bit smaller. All right, so this will be our light source, and based on this we will have very bright areas in here, and when you go in here you will have less light areas, and in here we will have the shadows, and also we have the big shadow in here. Okay, and all this blur will react with this light, so that these areas will be very bright. When you gradually go in, it will be lighter, as I said, but when you go underneath, because of the blur surface, there will be more shadows and darker areas in here. We have to consider all this before we start the blurs. Then only we can create more realistic fur. Okay, all right guys, so I think you guys got an idea. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete this now, and I'm going to create a new layer, and for this I'm going to name this one as guide. Okay, all right, so now what I'm going to do is let's go into the brushes, and in here I'm going to choose this very solid hard round brush, and we need the pressure sensitivity, and maybe we can also on the flow, and let's bring the opacity to maybe 80. All right, and let's choose the color from here, I, and select the color and press B for brush, and let's have some color samples in here. So I'm going to paint the color of this one, the main green color. So I'm just going to place this one in here. So this will be our mid-tone. Okay, so this will be the main color of that flip. Okay, so now I'm going to increase and decrease the brightness of this color. So let's start with the darker tone. So let's go in here to the color picker, go to the brightness, and let's bring this one down like this. Okay, maybe here. So this will be our darkest area. So I'm going to say okay, and I'm going to draw something like this in here. All right. Okay, and let's go in here again. I'm going to bring it towards the lighter side, and I'm going to think we can make it even more lighter. Maybe let's bring down a bit like this. Okay, all right, so this one look fine. So this one will be our lightest area. All right, so now maybe we can bring this one even more darker also if we want. Select this one and bring towards here. Okay, so this look fine. So these four are our color samples, so we need to draw around this line. Okay, if you guys want more details, you can blend these colors in here. So for this example, I'm not going to do that. I will stick to these samples in here, and let's go into the ellipse and let's start painting. First, I'm going to start with the darkest tone. Okay, as you guys already know, we will have more darker areas in here. When you go in here, we will have less darker areas. Okay, So for this, I'm going to go into the brushes and going to choose a brush with a soft brush. So we can choose this one, it's fine. All right, and make sure pressure sensitivity for your opacity is clicked and also your flow is clicked, okay? And now you can increase the size of this brush. So you have to increase the size like this, okay? So before we start, let's think about how our objects is going. Is it going to be very messy or is it going to be like in one direction, okay? So I'm going to make a little bit messy object and just flow from here. So our flow will start from here like this and go all the way to like this here, okay? Something like this along this line, okay? Something like that. So we will have things like this in here. All right, so let's go back in here and go in here, okay? Oops, we need this. Maybe. All right, so now I'm going to go in here and draw some lines like this. Okay, just start with top like that and just go with the flow, something along this line. Don't think too much, just go along with the line, okay? All right. Okay, so just continue drawing like this. Okay, so we will have less in this area, more like this in here. Like this. Okay, now we can bring the brush size a little bit smaller and draw like this. Okay. All right. I will make this part a little bit faster, guys. Okay, so now we can select the next color in here and now we start from here again as earlier, but this time we can bring the brush size a little bit smaller and we draw like this. Now what we can go is go back to the brush and now choose a hard brush like this, okay? Now we are choosing a hard brush, so we don't need a soft surface. Again, we go in here and choose the dark tone here again. And I'm going to draw something along this line, okay? Same as earlier, I'm just going to draw on top of this flow. Just always stick to the flow of the flow which you have created earlier. Again, you can make the brush size smaller and draw on top like this. Okay, when you go in the center, you can just randomly place them in here like this. Alright guys, so you can choose some of these darker tones in here, Alt and select, and you can place them in here. So as earlier, based on our lights. Now we can choose this color, the mid-tone color, and do the same. Always think from the light, where the light is going to be, guys, especially when you are designing realistic looking artworks in Photoshop, especially in 2D. You can have these outside also. Don't worry if it's outside, it will give a very nice look in the final effect. All right, guys. So you have to do some touch ups in here. And when you go in here, we need more darker tones, so we can choose the tone from here or in here. And also, if you feel like, you can bring it even more darker. And let's place some of them like this in here. I won't apply this dark tone in here, only to areas in the bottom, so that we can hide that roundness behind. And also, we won't find a lot of lights in that area as well. Alright guys, I think we are roughly getting there. Now let's go into the most lightest area, which is this one, and this will be our highlighted area. For this, we have to consider where the light is. Again, it's going to be in here and here. sorry, in here, these areas, we'll have more in here and we will have less in here. When we go below, I have very less, one or two maybe in here. Okay, so I'm going to go back and we're going to draw something like this. Before that, I'm going to make this one even more smaller, the brush size. Okay, and now let's start drawing like this. Alright guys, so now we have some sort of flare effect in here, but we can add in more details. Now we don't need this guide anymore, so we can select this area and delete from here. Okay, now select both of these objects. Maybe we can bring this one little bit smaller. Like this, it's fine. Now select both of them and make as one object. Okay. Now let's bring this one in here. So let's add in more details to this. Okay, so we have some flare effect in here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make this little bit more realistic than this now. So I'm going to choose the brush again, and now I'm going to choose colors from these areas. Make sure your flow is on, and let's bring this one to 90 92. And now let's choose colors randomly and draw on top like this in here. Okay, and choose darker tones from here and just place them in here based on your light source. Be some in here as well, just from here. So we can have some kind of depth for this artwork. Now we can choose the midtones. And the highlights. And when we go down, we will do the same with the darker tone. We can bring it even more darker like this in here, okay? Alright guys, so now we have this nice flare effect in here. Now we can add in a little bit more detail to this artwork. So let's say the color of the light will change the color of this flare also. For that, let's say the color of the light is yellowish. So I'm going to choose yellow color in here. Let's go to the hue. Something along this line. And I'm going to select this one on top. Just to apply on top, and I go to a soft brush again, and this time I'm going to bring it to 40s, and for this I'm going to select the color mode overlay, and let's bring the brush size bigger. Alright, so let's start from here. So you will have light, brightness in these areas like this. Some maybe in here, a little bit around these areas, and we can increase the brightness a bit to here, almost towards white, and you can place it in here. Okay, and when we go down, we will have darker tones, and for this I'm going to choose a purple color around this line, and we will apply like this. Okay, more you go down, more it will look more bluish and purplish, something like this. All right. Okay, and we can bring another white. And for this, I'm going to select screen or soft light. And we can apply in here. only to the brighter areas. Okay, and we can also choose a blue tone, a dark blue tone, and place them in these darker areas. All right, guys, I think this looks fine. Now let's go in here and choose the white color. Again, go to brush and choose hard brush and bring the size to small like this. And opacity, we can maybe keep to 30s or 40s and just draw, take out the lock and just draw on top like this. Okay, so we will have some of them very bright because they are reacting to the light. And we can increase the opacity also if you want. Okay, with the same selection, I'm going to choose multiple in here, And for this, I will choose a darker tone to have some more details to these areas. Like this in here, you can also have some of them in these areas as well. You can apply these to wherever you guys think there should be darker areas. All right, guys, this look fine. Now, as I said, we have to draw this a little bit bigger than its original size. So this is a 600 DPI. So when it may become smaller, it will look even more detailed. And now I'm going to draw the shadow. Draw a new layer and let's rename this one as shadow. And I'm just going to draw a darker tone and let's choose the brush, this one, a soft brush, and draw a shadow like this. Okay, now we go into the filter blur and apply a Gaussian blur. Let's bring it like this. All right, and you can place it somewhere around here like this. Maybe we can bring it a little bit more bigger. Right, this is fine. All right, guys, so that's how you guys can draw fur effect easily. So you can use the same tricks for hair or grass and stuff like that. So it's very easy to create. All you need to do is use the different tones of lights and paintbrush sizes to create this illusion of flow or particle effects. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching. See you guys in the next video.